Colossians 3:23.
Good morning and welcome to chapel. We open today in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please join me in saying the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
We will now sing our opening, I Am Jesus' Little Lamb.
Our first Bible reading is from Titus chapter 2, verses 11 through 15. For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people, training us to renounce ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in the present age, waiting for our blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all lawlessness, and to purify for himself a people for his own possession, who are zealous for good works. Declare these things, exhort and rebuke with all authority. Let no one disregard you. This is the word of the Lord.
Our second Bible reading is from Colossians 3, 23 and 24. Whatever you do, work heartily as for the Lord and not for men, knowing that from the Lord you will receive the inheritance as your reward. You are serving the Lord Christ. This is the word of the Lord.
Please rise for the reading of the gospel, which comes from Matthew 5, verses 13 through 16. You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how shall its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled under people's feet. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. This is the word of the Lord.
We will now sing, "I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light." You may be seated.
Hi, Trinity Lutheran School. This is Pastor Traister from St. Paul Lutheran Church in Matteson, Illinois, your neighbors to the south here. I'm very familiar with Trinity. In fact, all four of my children are graduates from Trinity Lutheran School, and I have a great love for Trinity, and I thank God for the great Christian education that my children got while they were there at Trinity. And so I look forward to the opportunity to be able to share God's word along with you because I know how important it is, and I know how much my children benefited from that. And it fits right into the text that that is for today, and that is the one that you're familiar with already from Colossians chapter 3, verse 23, where Paul writes, "Whatever you do, work heartily as for the Lord and not for men." I can relate with that text very well. Maybe you know what I'm talking about when I say some people are overachievers and some people are underachievers. My daughter is a classic overachiever. When she did her homework, when she was at Trinity there, she figured, well, if I study a half hour for the test, That's good, but if I study for an hour, another extra half hour, well, that's got to be even better. And she was always kind of going overboard with her homework, her study, with lessons that she turned in and things like that. A little more is always better for an overachiever. Then there are others who are underachievers, and I'm I can relate with those too. Underachiever says this. They say, "What's the least amount I have to do to get by? What's the least amount I have to do where I'll still get the job done, but I don't have to do anything extra?" Well, you maybe find yourself falling in one of those categories, either an overachiever, what else can I be doing? I should be doing more, or an underachiever, what's the amount I have to do to get the project done? Both of them get the project done, but they come at it a different way. Well, when it comes to being Christians, Paul calls us to be overachievers, to work like we're doing something for the Lord. Now, if you look at my desk right here, I tend to be a little bit of an overachiever myself. Maybe not a little bit, maybe more than a little bit. So here I am, I'm studying for things. I got my Bible open here on my desk. I've even got my my commentary for the Bible to understand the text a little bit better. I got my Greek text right here to understand, because you do lose something in the translation. And then I've got a little sheet here right here. In fact, there's even a little sticky note that says on here, "Do Chapel for Trinity." So see, I know that's a task that's there for me to do, and I want to do it well. Well, I want you to look at things in your life in the same way, that every single thing that you do is something you do for the Lord. Every single time you do something, you are mirroring who you are in Jesus Christ. Now, you look at my shirt here. I happen to wear my Blackhawks shirt today because I've kind of fallen in love with hockey. And, of course, three Stanley Cups makes it kind of important. I want people to know that I'm proud to be a Blackhawks fan. And so I wear it here on my shirt. Well, really, in a way, as Christians, we want people to know that we're Christians too. Not that we're bragging about that, no way, but we're bragging about the one whom we serve. We know Jesus Christ is our Lord and Savior. We know exactly what Jesus did for us. We know that when Jesus came to this world, he wasn't an underachiever. He was an overachiever. He was doing everything he could. He was touching people's lives. He was doing miracles. He was teaching. He was teaching through parables. He was going all the way to the cross. And even though he could have said, you know what, I can do this work maybe easier. No, he said, I'm going to go through the worst suffering ever. I'm going to literally go through hell for these people. And he never stopped a moment. He never said, hey, I need a break. He never thought, well, is there an easier way to do this? No, he was thinking about every single one of us. In fact, in one of his parables, Jesus said, I'm like a shepherd who has 100 sheep. And if I lose one sheep, I don't say, well, you know, at least I got 99. No, he goes after that one sheep. So Paul says, do everything that you do, everything that you do, as if you're doing it for the Lord. He says, put your whole heart, soul, life, everything you have into what you're doing. Let whatever you do, whatever you say, be a reflection of how Jesus loves you and what he did for you. And remember who Jesus is. There's a cross on my wall. I like to have it right there. In fact, there's a couple. There's a picture on the wall behind me there. We wear crosses sometimes. I've got a picture of a church building, the old church building, just on the other side of the camera here. On my other wall, I've got a picture of Jesus at the Last Supper with his disciples. And again, not to brag about that, but continue to remind me that every single thing I do is because of what Jesus has done for me. And the fact that, and it reminds me too, that Jesus is always thinking about me. You see, you have this confidence right now. And oh, it's so important right now because of everything that's going on around us where we're afraid. We're afraid of getting the COVID-19 virus. We're afraid for our families. We're many of the things that were solid and stable things in our lives in the past have been changed. They've been rocked. You guys can't even be in school right now. You have to do it all from home. And rely on Zoom and things like that, and you can't see your friends. Many of the things that you were used to doing before are gone. But you know what? Jesus is an overachiever. He is still, that hasn't stopped him from loving you, hasn't stopped him from being there with you, from watching over you. He still cares for you. Nothing about that is ever going to change. You can be rock solid, certain that whatever you do, that when whatever you do, Jesus is always with you. So here's what I try to do. I try to see other people through the lens of Jesus. Now, I'm wearing glasses right now, and if I were to, on these glasses, if I were to paint a big cross there, it would make it hard for me to see. I'd have to kind of look around that cross. But I want you to think of that cross of Jesus and his empty tomb as something you look through, not, and it won't impede what you're seeing, but you will see things and people in a totally different way when you see them through Jesus. So that person that makes me angry, that person maybe that hurt me, I can see them through my lens. And Paul even says that, don't do it like you're doing it for other people. Because when you do, you're going to say, well, do I like that person? Has that person been nice to me? Is that person attractive? Is that person someone I want to be my friend? That's the way men look at the world. But Jesus looks at it a totally different way. When Jesus looks at people in the world, he doesn't see color of skin. He doesn't see old or young. He doesn't see pretty or not so pretty. He doesn't see wealthy or not wealthy. He sees us all as sinners in need of being saved. And it was because when Jesus looked out from that cross, picture this, Jesus is hanging there on that cross. And the first thing he says, recorded in scripture from the cross, is, Father, forgive them. And them wasn't him picking out, well, which ones down there were nice to me? Which ones down there didn't want me to die on the cross? Which ones down there didn't scream, crucify him, crucify him? He said them, and he meant every single one of them. In fact, he was talking about you and me. He saw us as he's hanging from that cross. And hanging there on that cross, being punished for something he didn't do, he didn't deserve that, hanging there on that cross, he says, Father, forgive them. You see, when we see people in that light, we see them in a totally different way. Yeah, sometimes people are going to hurt us. They're going to harm us. They're not always going to be the nicest. We really want to do nice things for people who do nice things back to us. And we should do those nice things. But not just for them. Whatever you do with all your heart, soul, mind, whatever you do, do it as if you're doing it for the Lord. Picture that person as if that lens in front of you makes you not see that person, but see Jesus. And if that was Jesus right there, think about how much you love him. Think about how thankful you are that he's forgiven you all your sins. Think about how thankful you are that he's won heaven for you. And then see them and do it for them as if you were doing it for Jesus, because in effect you are. In effect you are. Remember what Jesus said, whatever you do for the least of these, my brothers, it's like you're doing it for me. Or better yet, you are doing it for me. And that changes everything. Now, you guys are learning a lot of great things at Trinity. You're learning about the wonders of your mind, and you're learning about math and science and reading and social studies and all those things. And then you're also learning about your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You're learning about a God who created the world and made you, who knit you together intricately in the womb of your mother as you were in her before you were born. That same God is with you in everything. And so as you learn, learn knowing that this is an incredible world that God has made for you and he's placed you in. And do it with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. And then take from there that knowledge that's up here and put it to work in your hands, in the way that you talk, in what you hear, in the way that you listen, in where your feet take you, in the thoughts that you have in your mind. Do it all. Do whatever you do, everything you do from your soul, from that soul that Jesus Christ bought back, and do it as if you're doing it for Jesus. I thank God for Trinity. I thank God that you're a part of that school. I pray God's blessing for you and for your family as you continue to grow in that. And I pray that God would make you an overachiever in everything you do, that you do it as if you're doing it for the Lord. God's peace.
Please join me in saying Luther's morning prayer. I thank you, my Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept me this night from all harm and danger. And I pray that you will keep me this day also, from sin and every evil, that all my doings in life may please you. For into your hands I commend my soul, my body and soul, and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen.
Please join me in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
We will now sing our closing song, Lamb of God.
But you have sent him from your side to walk upon this guilty sod and to become the Lamb of God. Your gift of till I